that jump out to you. Imagine, form pictures with it. Hallelujah. Stay till you see those things happen in your life. Stay till you see those truths in your life. Don't say things like, you know, many people use those kind of words. Those rich people, you have already excluded yourself. Hallelujah. You have to sit and see yourself being able to pay for anything and everything. You know that feeling of, there is no more land in this country. When I want to build my house, where will I get land from? That if you want to, you know that feeling of, if you want to get land now to build your house, just go to the outskirts of any city, because it's expensive. It's picture. Anything is picture. Are people not buying houses from people? And they will, you will buy a house, starting cost is 30 million naira. You will now bring down the house. Another cost again. Then you now start rebuilding. What are we talking about here? You don't need to go to a bush because you want to live. Hallelujah. You don't need to go to a bush. You can believe God. Hallelujah. Believe God for bigger things. You have to have those pictures of the blind seeing. You have to have those pictures of the deaf hearing. You have to have those pictures of yourself preaching to millions of people. This is the only way ministry can grow. Ministry does not grow accidentally. You don't preach to more people accidentally. You must see it. I remember in those days in usage, I would stand, you know, on there's a staircase somewhere on one field. I've said it to you many times. I will stand, I'll be praying, I'll close my eyes, then I will stretch my hands over the field. That field was big. So, I mean, that field is big, you know. So it feels like a crusade. So I would say, Jesus is Lord. Jesus is here. There's a lady to my left there. She's being healed right now of a problem. She's standing up from the wheelchair. Another crutch is over there. That blind woman just saw. You see it that way. You pray till you see it like that. Hallelujah. I've told you before that there was a time when this church, amen, was just one, two rows, amen. And it was even looking big, hallelujah. You know, we're very happy. Like, it's a stop at where some of these people are stopping, amen. And we'll be very happy, hallelujah. People came to church, amen. Then I'll be preaching. When I'm preaching, I'll start telling them, I'm seeing more than the people that are sitting down here. You are wondering, why am I this hard? It's because you people, you are only seeing these people. Me, I'm in a stadium. Hallelujah. I said, I'm preaching in a stadium as I'm talking to you like this. It now got to a point where people did not used to come plenty to church. In that sense, I'll be like, one, two. Alright? But if I come to church, I will not be happy. Not distraught. That's not what I'm talking about. I'll be like, people didn't come to church today. We need to get out to more people. It's the same number that has been coming before. But something has shifted inside that makes what looked good to you before to look small. You understand what I'm saying? Glory to God forevermore. It must form a picture. You could meditate on a truth till you see it. And let me tell you, truly, I've preached to thousands of people. Hallelujah. I have. Amen. I have. Glory to God forevermore. It all starts from a picture. Hallelujah. It all starts from seeing the possibility. Hallelujah. And moving towards it. I'm the one Jesus loves. I'm the one Jesus wants to use mightily. You begin to see it. I'm the one who is going to the ends of the nations. So that voice is talking in your mind, but you are small now. But you don't have money now. You say, no, not by power, not by might, but by the Spirit of God. It is God who makes me an able minister. I don't need to qualify by myself. God has qualified me. I'm standing before presidents of countries. I'm standing before nations to preach the gospel to them. I'm the pastor to presidents. I'm the pastor to governors. I'm the pastor to ministers. I'm the pastor to senators. Nowhere is hard for me. Nothing is too hard for me. I've gotten to a place with the pictures in my heart where I know that there is no place I go to preach unless I'm not interested. This power must fall tangibly. I don't double think it unless I'm not interested. That the power of God will not fall on the people unless I'm not interested. What did I say? Unless I'm not interested. This picture. Hallelujah. His picture now. His picture. Even only if I don't want to. It's only if I don't want to. Hallelujah. Even when I am tired. Even when I am very, very tired. If I want the power to fall, it will fall mightily. It's a picture. Those days when we sat down and saw people scattering in our minds. The place is just scattering. Hallelujah. filling our minds with people. We say there are 20 people here, and then you'll be counting. I hear 20. Then one day I heard one man of God say there are 200 people here who will fall out under the power now. Ushers, count them for me. Then I saw the picture. It changed. It doesn't take time. If your heart is opened to the word of God, when one picture enters, every other picture will be displaced. I know what I'm saying to you. If you have an open heart, because I saw it, 200, falling out under the power. The next major meeting I had, I was just laughing. I said, you know, I can say 100 people should fall out under the power now, and they will fall out under the power. Everybody was looking at me, what was going to happen here? And I said, okay, anyway, let's just start counting. There are 100 people now under the power everywhere. Start counting. 1, 2, 3, 36, 40 something, 50 something, 86. I said there are 30 more, something, 99. I said, now count to 100. The 100 one like this, it's all of them at once, like four of them at the same time. 100, like 104, 105. But is it that power was not there before? Is it that the power was not there before? Sometimes it's not hard work you need, it's just change of picture. Hallelujah. You could meditate on the truth till you see it. See yourself calling people's names by word of knowledge. See yourself giving them their phone numbers by word of knowledge. See yourself telling them their house address. Don't say that some ministers, they are so vast in these things, you have excluded yourself. See yourself as the one who is doing it. See yourself, if Renard Bonke won 70 million souls, let me tell you something. It is a curse when we stop where the Father stopped. It is a blessing when we start where the Father stopped. It means that there is somebody who is about to replicate and double and triple such results. But did you know it was possible before? Have you really seen it tangibly? Has it formed to you that nations can open up to you the way it opened up to Renard Bonke? Africa was African technology. They mix the thing for you. They give you sleep. You don't wake up. Hallelujah. When they used to use human beings for sacrifice. You know. So Africa was dark from beginning to the end. You know what God did for Renard Bonke? Renard Bonke slept and saw a blood-washed Africa. He saw an Africa dipped in blood. From that day, the force and motion of his life changed. That means that pictures can change the direction of your life. That's the meaning. Because God knows, I want this guy to take over places for me. So God says, dash him on vision. He takes the vision. He sees a blood-washed Africa. And as he sees that blood-washed Africa, it starts propelling him. It starts moving him forward. Then the next thing that begins to happen is Africa just begins to open of its own accord. Because once the picture changes, the manifestations happens of its own accord. God's greatest work with you is to change your pictures, to accommodate the fact that what he has said he will do it, he will do it. That's the greatest work in fulfilling purpose, to be able to agree with God. Because think about it, naturally you can never move anything by yourself. I hope you know that. Naturally, there's nothing you can move by yourself. You cannot enter a new country by yourself. If they don't give you visa, what will happen? There are so many things you cannot do with your strength. There are so many things you can't do by yourself. That means God's greatest work is not to give you enough money to enter the country. God's greatest work is to, God's greatest job is to bring your mind into a place where it sees that dream as a possibility. That God told you that you will have chains of industries that will span through the ends of the earth and through generations, because he wants to use it to sponsor the gospel. Never think about money with those kind of things. Dwell on the vision till you can accept it. Because once you accept that vision, everything will start responding to it. Your environment responds to the visions in your heart. When God deals with the visions in your heart, everything is taken care of. Do you hear what I'm saying this night? Because people are about to stand up from this place to go and begin to do big things. In the name of Jesus. God is pushing you to a place where you'll be able to accept those things. Where you'll be able to say of a truth that this thing is happening in my life that God has said. Yeah. You may know that God wants to use you. You may know that God wants to bless you. You may know that God wants to prosper you. But you have never settled down to daydream about it. You are just escaping from visions. You are just escaping from those words of prophecies in your notes. You are escaping from it because you have not yet seen how it will happen physically. Stop escaping from all the words of prophecy that God has put in your heart. Sit down there. Stay in it. Soak yourself in the picture till you know that there are no devils enough in this world to stop this thing from happening. There is no government policy enough to stop this thing from happening. There is nothing in this world that can stop these things from happening to me. They told the man of God. They said the FCT minister is, how do you say it to him? Okay, they said he's destroying churches. And he will come and destroy your church soon. No? He didn't answer at first. They said, this man will destroy your church. What did he say? He said, 1 billion of that minister cannot destroy this church. That was where the case ended. He has been seeing himself. When God says, I have set you over nations, believe what he's saying to you. He has really set you over nations. He has. He has set you over the nations. You have to meditate to a point where you know that there is no government policy in any part of the world that is enough to stop you. Bishop Oyedepo was in the airplane. Eh? Hear this. Bishop Oyedepo was in the airplane, in his aircraft, going to another country. He was about to land when he realized that he didn't take his visa. He said, my visa is not with me. They said, Kai, what do we do, sir? He said, call the country. Tell them I'm coming. They put a call through to them. They said, Bishop Oyedepo is coming into the country and he doesn't have his visa with him. The person that picked the call didn't know who Bishop was. So he said, okay, give me a minute. Let me check. So he called back and called Bishop. I said, hello. Okay, sir. It wasn't Bishop that picked those people. He said, hello. It is all right. He can land on personal recognition. I said, he has made you the head of the heathen. That's what the Bible says. He says, a people that you do not know shall serve you. He said, as soon as they hear of you, they shall submit themselves to you. This thing that I'm putting in your heart is making you to take the nations. His son was the one sharing the testimony. So, his son now said that people will think that it is because Bishop Oyedepo is known around the world. Is that not it? That's what many people think. He's bishop. That's the problem. That's the picture I'm seeing. You have to get to that place where you start talking like, he's me. Why will you go and get visa and they will deny you? His son now said, don't think that it's because he's bishop, because this thing has happened to him before. In the 80s, when nobody knew him, where he got to the border of an African country, he didn't make his visa. And they asked him, where is your visa? He said, I forgot to make it. I want to go and preach the gospel. I forgot to get my visa. They said, make sure you get it next time, enter. That thing starts from inside. How I wish you will rubbish money in your mind today and see that money indeed is nothing. That money is nothing to the fulfillment of your future. That all you need for the fulfillment of your future is just a picture that is powered with prayers. That all you need is just a God-sized vision, a God-sized picture. Because money cannot stop you. Nothing in this world can stop you. Money cannot stop you. Nothing can stop you. Nothing in this world can stop you. Nothing can stop you. Hallelujah. 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 There are no devils in this world that can stop you. I said people are going out of this place. You see, some of you are having your space in the next government of this country. Do you believe what I'm saying to you? I'm talking to you as a controller of the nations. I'm talking to you as one that holds the keys to the doors of nations. You too see yourself as one who does that. But I'm talking to you that somebody who has realized that. And I open up sectors to you in this nation. Take your seat in the presence of the Lord. The fire is doing you up. Hallelujah. Take your seat. Glory to God forevermore. Glory to God forevermore. Until you conceive it, you might not get that miracle. You must be intentional. Use your imagination intentionally. You know, this is why you are praying in other tongues when you are seeing those pictures, because you are being intentional. You want to give those pictures breath. Hallelujah. So what do? You start speaking in other tongues. The imagination can work for you. Hallelujah. Your imagination can work for you. Your imagination can work against you. Hallelujah. So use your imagination as well. What did I say? You know, 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 3 to 5 helps us realize that the greatest place of battle is in the mind. Hallelujah. It is where? In the mind. You cast down every imagination, every high thing that wants to exalt itself against the knowledge of God. Glory to God. So use your imaginations aright. Use your imaginations positively. Hallelujah. Look, there's a way the world trains you. Give me this cup of water. The world always trains people to see things negatively. So when you show the world this cup, right, and you ask them, what are you seeing? They will tell you that they are seeing a glass of water that is half empty. But when you ask somebody whose mind is renewed with the word of God, who sees things from a bigger perspective, he will tell you that he's seen a glass of water that is half filled. Change the way you see things. Are you hearing what I'm saying to you? Change the way you see things. Employ your imagination positively. Employ it positively. If you can imagine it, it can be done. Are you hearing me? It may take time, but it can be done. Once it is within the range of your imagination, it can be done. The things that were Marvel hero movies many years ago have become reality today. I hope you know that. If they showed cars in those days, it would be cartoon. I hope you know that. But it has become a reality today. You can break lack off yourself forever. See with your imagination. You see, you have to get to that point where you can see better with your heart than you can with your eyes. You can know that you are called. Many times, some people, they know they are called, but they cannot see themselves fulfilling the call. They can't see themselves doing the call. You must know that you are called, and you must see yourself fulfilling the call of the ministry on a large scale. If you don't strengthen the pictures you see intentionally, it will become hazy. It will become dark. You will become negative. Hallelujah. It's like a muscle. You know, when you don't use a muscle, the muscle atrophies. It does what? It atrophies. It becomes smaller. It looks like it's dying. You know, it reduces in strength. The number of cells inside reduces, becomes smaller. Atrophy. Do you understand that? So, you can break lack off yourself forever by just allowing the pictures of abundance to rise. You can break fear off your life forever by just allowing the pictures of boldness to rise from within you. Am I going to finish this message today? You can break lack off your life forever. If you don't do it, if you don't do this thing intentionally, other people will sell their pictures to you and you will buy it. If you are not living by your own pictures, you are definitely living by somebody else's pictures. I hope you know that. Either if it's your parents' pictures or the pictures of your friend, you are living by one picture. So you must be intentional about your pictures. The most powerful things on earth are intangible things. Hallelujah. Those pictures are more powerful than tangible things. Hebrews 11:3 tells us that the things that were seen were made out of the things that were not seen. Hallelujah. Stay with the pictures in your heart. If you stay with those pictures in your heart forever, they will manifest finally. If you stay with those pictures in your heart forever, they will manifest when? Finally. The teaching of God's word will form new pictures to you. They will form new pictures in you. Every fear in you, hear this part, is one of the most interesting parts. Every fear in you has a source. Everything you are afraid of is connected to something. Hallelujah. And God's word will uproot that thing. The word of God will handle four areas for you. Four areas. The first area is ignorance. If you handle ignorance, the word of God will build new pictures in you if you are ignorant. And that's why we have to just keep telling people your sins are forgiven and not assuming that they know it. Hallelujah. We have to keep telling people the gospel, not assuming that they know it. We have to keep saying it. Ignorance is a major thing. Amen. But the word of God will undo ignorance. If you want advancement, concentrate on the word. Hallelujah. You need focus with doctrine. Are you hearing me? What did I say? You need focus with doctrine. You're the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You need to focus on that. Hallelujah. Your sins are forgiven. You need to focus on that. Hallelujah. You have been saved with an eternal redemption. You need to focus on that. Hallelujah. Are you hearing what I'm saying to you? Focus. Stop spreading yourself too much. Spreading yourself too much will affect you. Focus your attention on the truth that you want new visions in. You want to break through in the area of evangelism, and you are even on how to find marriage partner. 10 books on that. You will evangelize to your soon-to-be wife. Hallelujah. Have a focus. What did I say? Focus. You want to focus on prosperity, the light of God's word. Read books, hear messages around it. Focus your attention. Get books and messages. Hallelujah. Number two thing that the word of God deals with is unpersuadableness. Unpersuadableness. The word of God, unpersuadableness is that the word of God has come, but you are still not persuaded. Somebody can sit down in this meeting and miracles are taking place and say, I don't believe anything that is going on here. He's still not persuaded. The word of God, we deal with unpersuadableness. Unpersuadableness is that the word of God says that you are the yield of God. And you say, yes, even the Greek word is this, the Hebrew word is this, but you are still lying down on that bed. You are still acting sick. It has not entered. That's unpersuadableness. And the word of God will correct that. Number three, errors. Errors. The word of God will correct any error that you might find yourself in. Hallelujah. You might be doing something again and again, and it is not working out. The word of God might reveal or will reveal to you what next you should do to make that thing work out. What you are not doing well enough to make that thing, you know, work out. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? The word of God is able to show you that. Number four, laziness. The word of God will tackle laziness in your life by giving you instructions in righteousness. Hallelujah. The word of God will stretch you. It's the word of God that will give you pictures of how you should spend time in prayers. Hallelujah. Now let me talk to you about the ways these pictures form. Hallelujah. The way these pictures form. These pictures form through the teaching of God's word. I've already spoken extensively on that. Teachings enlarge your heart. It makes you to see new pictures. Number two way the word of God, the pictures form is through association. Through what? Where you go matters. What did I say? Where you go matters. Where you go to hear God's word matters. It matters. You are reading Righteous by Faith today. Reading Padlock Destiny tomorrow. It matters. You are hearing that you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus today. And tomorrow you are hearing that God is angry with you. And you are going to that meeting. It matters. Stop going everywhere. Don't use sentiments for your destiny. Associations will produce new pictures for you. There are people here You need to change your associations. There are some other people here. All your associations, they are actually here. But you need to change yourselves. Let this word bring repentance to you. Change the way you talk amidst yourselves. Change the way you talk to yourselves. Address people like they are going far. Stay with people who address you like you are going far. Go to places that will help you think big. Go to places that will help you think big. That preacher of the gospel, he was having only few people, no breakthrough in ministry. Then he decided, I will go to Fred Casey Price's church. He will go to Fred Price's church that had thousands of people. Sit down there every Sunday morning and just be watching people cleaning the floor, or the church getting filled up with thousands of people. He did that for weeks. In a short period, he grew to have a church that was in the tens of thousands. Just pictures. It means that you know what has big got to do with the gospel? What big has to do with the gospel is that people can be saved at once, right? Only 100 people or 100,000 people can be saved at once. That's what big has to do with the gospel. That's why you have to think big. Big has to do with the gospel in the place that only 1,000 can be saved at once, or only 1 million can be saved at once. Big. If you know how your picture can change the eternal destinies of people, you will change those pictures. It's impartation. It is association. Let me say this to you. Never be afraid. Hear this very well. Never be afraid or shy of saying the truth or the things that your heart desires. Stop saying things like it's not about mega churches. When you know that God has called you to a big church, to raise a big church. Stop saying things like ministry is not about miracles. When you know that God has called you to work in the power ministry, in His power. Hallelujah. When you know that God has called you to be an evangelist, to display His power to the ends of the earth, and you are shouting ministry is not about miracles. Stop saying things like ministry is not about numbers. When you know that God has asked you to have a lot of people, saying things like that will kill something inside you. And when you are trying to resurrect it, there will be a problem. There will be a problem. Take correction this night. Take adjustment this night. Adjust your mind to bigness. I beg you in the name of Jesus. You know that the only reason I'm begging you is for your sake. You know I have nothing to gain from this, because my pictures are taken care of. I will still break forth whether you are around or not. I will break forth because I'm planting the word in my heart. But I want you to be there when I'm there. I want you to be there when I'm there. I want you to be there when these other people are there. I want you to change your mind. I want you to change the way you see. I want you to change the way you think. I want you to stop saying things that are killing your faith, no matter how good they look. Before, you could believe God for a lot of things. Now, what you can believe God for is very limited, because somebody came and told you that God does not take care of that. Please, I beg you. I beg you. God is interested in numbers. God is interested in growth. God is interested in increase. God is interested in finances. There is wealth and healing in redemption. That's why it says that the chastisement of our peace, of our prosperity, was put upon Jesus. What we needed for nothing to be missing, for nothing to be broken in our lives, was put upon Jesus. Associate with people that lead you to pray. Associate with the right people. Associate with people that have big minds. Associate with these people through their books. You should read Kenneth Copeland's books if you want to break out in finances. You should read Kenneth Hagin's books if you want to break out and be strong in faith. You should read E.W. Kenyon's books if you want something to jump in your words. You should hear Cornel Moyo's messages if you want to be able to do big things and speak like a prophet. Hallelujah. You should hear Pastor Tyra's messages if you want to have a supernatural mindset that never leaves you. Associate with them through their books.
associate with them through their messages.
Glory to God forevermore. If God allows you to meet them in flesh and blood, ask the right questions. Don't be proud. Isaiah chapter 30 verse 20 tells us that our teachers will not be removed from us to a corner. He said, but our eyes will see our teachers and we will hear a voice behind us saying, this is the way, go thou in it. Stop going to places where you will be double-minded. Cast down. Stop going to places where you will be double-minded, where you will be cast down all the days of your life. And yet this, the interpretation of your encounter with people matters. You hear people saying things like, we are not interested in pastors telling us about how much they are using. It is not the gospel. Meanwhile, somebody else is, your breakthrough is in that testimony. What will have helped your faith is in that testimony. Archbishop Idahosa took a man into his bedroom, a man of God, and said, look at my bed. The bed was very big. Archbishop said, big bed for big vision. The man said, when he said that, I said it in my heart that this man has missed it in ministry. That's all he could see. When you, the mere fact that if your heart was in honor, Archbishop just taking you into his house, something is already happening to you. You enter his bedroom, he is telling you big bed, big vision. What you are saying is that, sir, can I lie down on the bed so that I can start having big visions? For some other people, because of evil influence, terrific influence, influences from the pit of hell, they will start saying that he has missed it. Always try to interpret things in the right light, not through criticisms. You are not a critic, you are a believer. Hallelujah. The third way these pictures form is through encounters of the God kind. And many of you, as the power of God rests upon you this evening, you will begin to have those encounters. It is by this encounter that Peter was able to enter into the house of the Gentiles and win them over to Christ. He could not change his picture ordinarily, so God gave him a vision. Encounters. So some people need those encounters. Not everybody needs the encounter. You hear me? Some of you don't need it. Some people need it, for an extra push. Some people already believe, whether there's an encounter or there's no encounter. But any of these three ways are the ways that pictures could form in your mind. Now, what are the things that can limit God or the pictures that have been formed in your mind? Those big pictures. Number one, the cares of this world. The cares of this world can limit God in your life. The cares of this world can limit the pictures that are forming in your mind. You hear people saying things like, if you are not depressed, it means you are not paying attention. You know people talk like that. That you are not depressed because you are not paying attention to what's going on. That's a lie. Paying attention is what is distracting you. Trying to pay attention to everything that is happening on social media just to be current is what is distracting you. That's what is distracting you. Hallelujah. The cares of this world distracts people. See, you know David said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. This is the same David that Absalom wanted to kill. Amen. Do you know that you can be complaining to the fact that Absalom rebelled instead of giving thanks to God that the kingdom was preserved? Two ways of seeing the same situation. You'll be complaining about Absalom when God delivered you and delivered your kingdom from that terrible person. Stop looking at the problem. Look at the world. Mark chapter 4 verse 19 tells us that the cares of the world choked the word of God in some people's lives. Hallelujah. Look at Psalms chapter 46 verse 10 says, be still and know that I am God. Settle down and hear God. Stop jumping up and down. If you will take the limits of God, you will have to diminish the impute of ungodliness or the dunks of this world coming into your house. Hallelujah. You will have to steel yourself. You will have to quiet yourself. You will have to ask yourself, is there a place that is better than where I am now? Is there more to what I am experiencing now? You have to be able to settle down to be able to ask yourself those questions. Spend time with the world. Unplug from the world. Put your mind on God. You can be addicted to sports, so I hope you know.
don't want to know everything that is happening in the world. Make a decision to put God first. Unplug the TV set. Stop using your laptop for films. That's not what they are for. They are for messages. They are for you to see the display of the power of the Holy Ghost. Stop using it for series film. Some of you have all the series in the world on your laptop. Maybe that's an exaggeration. But in fact, maybe it's even possible. Plus hard drive, when it cannot contain the shelf again. As the thing is coming out, you are sending message. Please, do you have Flame season 4? Please, do you have... How do you know everything that comes out afresh? And you don't know the ones that have come out since over 2,000 years ago. You don't even know God's word that has come out. They produced God's word since 2,000 years ago. You can still not quote John 3:16. Say, is it that place where you say, but God so loved Satan that he created his only begotten son? Meanwhile, Avengers come out. You know that Avengers is available. This one comes out. You know that it's available. That one comes out. You know that it's available. Come on. Hold on. Hallelujah. What did I say? Change the way you are thinking. Hallelujah. Use your systems for good things. The fear of risk. You don't have to be afraid to surrender to God. Hallelujah. If you have a dynamic relationship with God where you are learning a lot of things, the fear of the unknown will be gone. The fear of the unknown will be what? Gone. When God sends you, he will put the desires in your heart and you will love it. So don't be afraid of those things of what if it's a place I don't like? What if I will die? You are safer in God's plans than away from God's plans. Hallelujah. You remember those lepers in 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 3 to 4? Their only chance of survival was to enter into the camp of the enemies. And they took it well. You remember when Jesus was walking on the sea and he saw the disciples walking on the sea? He told Peter to come. Peter was afraid. They were afraid to walk on the sea. But they were still going to drown in the boat anyway. They were still going to drown. Hold on to God. It's the only place where there is safety. In him is safety. In him is safety. Be at that place where if you don't have instructions to do something bigger than you, you will be abnormal. You will be bored. Commit yourself without questions. Commit yourself without questions. Number 3, the fear of man. What will they say about me? They will criticize me. Listen to me. If you will leave anything, you have to know that people will always want to make themselves look good by criticizing you. So don't bother about people's opinions. Stop feeling like you need everybody's acceptance. God is enough for you. Don't hurt people on purpose, but don't just care about their opinions when they are trying to stop you from doing God's work. Hallelujah. An example is Joseph and his brothers. Hallelujah. Stop fearing persecutions. You will surely be criticized if Jesus Christ was. Number 4, the fear of success. What will happen to me if I succeed? Won't I become proud? Won't I miss it? Won't I lose it? The fear of success makes some people want not to aspire to be successful. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid of succeeding. The word of God will take care of any bad attitude that can crop up if you succeed. Hallelujah. Fear comes from having an imagination of failure. See success. If you can see it, your faith will bring it to pass. Paint the pictures. You can't experience what you don't see. Meditate on the pictures till it becomes a hope. Then none can take it away from you. It is not enough to know that you will prosper and to know that your healing is in Isaiah 53 verse 5. Until you see it and see yourself well, you might not go far with that truth. You must see it. And as you are seeing, empower those pictures.
You've been listening to Pastor Dr. Tara Akinkwade, the senior pastor of the Standing Church. We believe you've been blessed by God's word and are set to experience miracles. If you have never made the decision to be saved and would like to receive Jesus into your life, please say the following words out loud. Lord Jesus, I confess you as Lord over my life. I believe that you died for me and that God raised you from the dead. I receive all that you made available for me through your death, burial, and resurrection. I declare right now that I am a child of God. I am free from sin, and I am the righteousness of God. Amen. Congratulations, you are now saved. We are so glad you made the decision to be saved today. If you would like to share your testimony with us, you can contact us on our social media platforms on Facebook at The Standing Church and on Instagram at the_standing_church. You can also call us on 081-3477-3145 or visit our website at www.thestandingchurch.com. God bless you.